Pakistan against Sri Lanka. Both teams coming off a win. Remember, Sri Lanka, we were almost writing them off at the very start. They looked disappointing, inexperienced captain. Pakistan, they started off in the worst possible fashion against the West Indies in Trent Bridge. But both teams have put their ship right, and which is what makes for a very spicy contest between these two. The very fact that they're both on the sheet with 2 points each.
Absolutely. And I think both the teams will be looking to do that that tactical change. You know, because now for Pakistan also coming from Nottingham, wicket was having that extra bounce. Bristol is not going to have that. The wicket is more on the drier side. Similarly for Sri Lanka as well. You know, so both the teams, I think, will look to look at their playing 11. Maybe Pakistan not that much because they had the spin option in their playing 11. But Sri Lanka for sure is going to think of possibly bringing back Jeevan.
Well, let's look at the Pakistan squad first. You're saying possible changes. Do you see an maybe an Imad Wasim?
That's the only discussion I think they will have. Apart from that, and even if Imad Wasim comes in, you know, leaving out? Hafiz had a good game, so Hafiz will continue. Once again, the discussion will be around Shoaib. That's the only possible slot. But I think they will continue with Shoaib Malik. Yeah. So I don't see any changes in Pakistan playing 11 for tomorrow's match.
Yeah, the last time around we had a preview, we said very clear Haris Sohail makes way for Shoaib Malik coming in. Should have been there in the first place. But Sri Lanka, let's have a look at Sri Lanka's playing 11.
So Jeevan Mendis definitely is going to come into this team. They need him. They need somebody to give a bit of stability in the batting. Angelo Matthews is having a terrible time of it. They won't replace him, but they look to replace. And I think Thirumane also might give way. They might have a chance. They'll look at the other fast bowler to replace Thirumane. He's not been having a great time of it.
But worry is,
Lakmal had a tough game.
Lakmal is the only one.
So I think Jeevan Mendis will come in place of Lakmal.
That's almost sure. Yeah,
that's pretty much sure. Apart from that, Kushal Mendis had a tough outing in the first couple of matches. So that's another discussion.
They rate Avishkar Fernando as well. For Thirumane, they rate him as one of the bowlers who can do something. Remember that while they won it, it didn't start very convincingly. They collapsed against, you know, their batting is a real concern to them. That's something that they'll be thinking about and saying that, you know, what do we need to do? And for Pakistan, of course, there are two tosses before a game. So one toss is actually on the field. The other toss is which Pakistan side will land up today. You know, is it the Dr. Jekyll Pakistan or is it Mr. Hyde Pakistan? You know, which side will they turn up today, you know?
Which also makes it difficult, not just for either Safraz or the inexperienced captain on the Sri Lankan side, which is Dimuth Karunaratne, but it makes it tough for all of you. Because remember, you can wait till the start of the first ball of the innings, but maybe don't wait for that long. Try and make the core of your team. Get to my11circle.com, download the app if you haven't, select Pakistan versus Sri Lanka and create your own team. That's the man you've got to play against. Always got a smile on his face. Always likes to show off when he's got a team right. Just wondering how he would have been as selector, because he's playing selector here. Can you see him as chief selector?
That's the point. I see him as the Prime Minister of the country in time to come. Honestly, I'm not joking.
But as Prime Minister of the country, also chief selector, aren't you?
If he
puts his mind to it, then he can do anything. As simple as that. He can be selector, he can be coach, he can be president, he can be prime minister, like he said.
But we've talked about the team selection. Just to finish off on the discussion of Pakistan versus Sri Lanka, who in your mind has the edge going ahead in that clash?
I think it's going to be another exciting match tomorrow. You know, and the reason for that is the wicket is similar to what we see here. You know, so it's going to assist a little bit of spin. It's not going to be over the top English condition kind of a wicket, and we've seen it with Afghanistan Australia game as well. You know, so there will be a little bit of help for spinners as well. So two Asian teams playing, I think, you know, that will make the contest interesting. Sri Lanka will be happy that they're saying bye to Cardiff for a while and going to Bristol where they can breathe easily. So I think Sri Lankan batsmen will be happy to play on that track. And once you play on a difficult track and you come back to playing on a better track, you're always more excited about batting and, you know, you feel comfortable. So that's something which I'm expecting from tomorrow's match. So all in all, hope we see a cracker of a game and some lots of runs and some good strategies. And as long as there is even even contest, you know, it always makes a great viewing. Like you saw it from today's match as well. So tomorrow, I'm hoping for that kind of a game.